From Canada, Lori Ann Hall.
We'll keep an eye out for Laura Hall from Canada, gold medalist in the 3000 representing the University of Calgary, I should say. Okay, perfect. She could be one to watch here. So, Natalia Yabrich lined up next to Veronika Antsova. Roseanne Grenier on the front line as well. And they get underway.
Now introducing the rest of the field.
Immediately we see Paul just having a look on the inside. The 206 cap sitting in seventh position at the moment.
Shino Misaki, helmet 9 from Poland. Federica Mafia, helmet number 210 from the Czech Republic. Holger Kaczmarek, helmet number 211
Yabrich
from Kazakhstan.
At the front.
Helmet number 12.
Taking it easy at the moment.
Arina Ilyichenko.
About positioning for
Julia
lap number 4.
Helmet number 14 from the USA. Thalia Staley. Helmet number 14 from the Netherlands. Julin Minsu de Visser.
So Rap Yabrich from Antosova.
Abigail Max.
And it's Anna Petishnik who's moved up into third.
Helmet 18
but,
from Austria.
A change up the front there.
Helmet 219
Susanna Kosova from the Czech Republic has moved up into the lead.
220 from Jabrich. Sydney U. Turpany.
And Antosova sitting in Norway, third.
223 from Republic of Korea, Park Ji-woo. Helmet 24 from Switzerland, Jasmine Gunter. And helmet 225 from Kazakhstan, Margarita Atumeva.
So the two Canadians just sitting at the back. So they got the belt at the beginning of this lap to indicate that the first intermediate sprint is coming up very shortly. They're rounding the final bend. All about positioning. And Hall just sitting around the outside here. Now the speed goes up as they prepare for the first set of points available in this mass start. Now Jabrich moving to the front. Looks like Jabrich has taken the first set of points. Got tight at the end there with Kosova in the hunt, but looks like first sprint points are with Jabrich, Antosova and Merckx. Kurtseva now
our last sprint result
going up into the front. So they're all bunched up at the moment. Now, it may look a little peculiar if you're not used to the mass start, but the the athletes that are looking to win this may not be too bothered about the intermediate sprints. They're looking to, big wobble there. Ina Storalid was the one that suffered the most out of that one. Norwegian stay in the pack. There was just a little slip, and that caused a few of the athletes to have a wobble, but all looks good now. But as I was saying, may look a little peculiar. They're just jostling for position, creating this aerodynamically efficient train. As they go through the end of lap seven, they get the bell, and we have another sprint on our hands. Kosovo is up the front. And she's managed to hold that position. She was there before, but didn't end up with any points. Now you see that she's been dropped.
Looks like this time I'm number 24.
And it's Günther who's pressed to the front. And then a quick move from Veronika Antisova. Pechnik also in the hunt for points here, but back up to the front. It's the Canadian now. So Hall taking the points. Hall from Canada, the gold medalist in the 3,000 meters, taking the points on lap eight. So now they start the push to the final lap. Günther, who took the points in the intermediate from Merckx and Kosova. But now the race to the finish begins. Roseanne Grenier moving up front from teammate Laura Ann Hall. Trying to just break the train up a little bit, but it hasn't happened. They've just eased off again. So Hall leading the way. Sjobrand was in the mix there as we go into our next sprint. And Natalia Jabridge up at the front now, pushing hard. And it is Petrichnik from Austria who has taken the points from Jabrich. And to serve it in the mix as well, to 3 points for her in the sprints. So now we have the push to the finish. Sjobrand from Norway making a break here. She's pushed really hard now. Do we have a four there? And Sjobrand has really broken open the path here. Leading from Jabrich and Pechnik. But look how far ahead she is. She's gone 20 meters clear, Sjobrand. Juliberg Sjobrand, I should say. Coming up to the line to complete lap number 14. So Sjobrand miles ahead. Fast lap of 32:36. And chasing it down, that is the intermediate sprint results. After the three sprints, those are the points that will be gained by Well, Jabrik's merchant Gunther at the top of the pile. Now a real push here from Roseanne Grenier. And they've hauled in Sjobrin. Grenier leading up the front, and Takahashi, who took the gold medal here at the test event, presses on to the front of the pack. Takahashi working hard in front of her Japanese teammate, Shino. So we sprint through now to the medals, and crossing the line, it is Shino Misaki ahead of her teammate Takahashi Yuka, and in the end it was Josephine Hamrell who made it through in third position for Germany. But what a sprint from Shino Misaki at the end there. All builds to the last 400 meters. There was a little spurt from Sjobrin at lap 14, and then she was hauled in.
Takahashi Yuka looks like she finished in second with Germany, Josephine Pieke Heberel in the third.
So, Heimel taking third from Takahashi second, and there is the wobble, and it was Storalid who suffered the most out of that one. And then here is the break from Sjobrin from Norway. She really went out hard after the final sprint. And then here come the Japanese athletes taking over from Roseanne Grenier of Canada, and the sprint to the finish. In the end, Grenier didn't have enough and got pipped on the post by the two Japanese athletes and by Heimel of Germany. Well, what a day for Japan. Shino Misaki coming in for this race has shown everyone how to do it, taking the 60 points, having not scored any points in the intermediate sprints. In fact, all of the top three were out of the points in the sprint races. They were focused on getting over the line first after lap 16. Park Ji-woo coming through in fourth place over the line. So she gets 10 points for that. Maffei from Italy in fifth from Merckx of Hungary. Well, the Japanese crowd pretty delighted with that. We're just waiting for confirmation. Look at the delight. Shino and Takahashi, first and second for Japan. Can't quite believe it. Congratulations coming in from Hamrell, who took third place for Germany. And confirmation of the remaining places in the top eight. Park Ji-woo collecting 10 points for finishing fourth. Does finish fourth overall from Italy's Federica Maffei. And as you can see here, Abigail Merckx of Hungary with 3 points from the last sprint, the final sprint, adding 2 points from sprints one and two. Finishes in sixth place. Now, they haven't been confirmed yet, so we have to be a little bit careful. But it looked pretty clean at the end. And there's the provisional medalists, Shino Misaki and Takahashi Yuka from Hamel Josephine. Brilliant race.
Begin at 11:22. 11:22 start time for the men's last start.
So, fantastic stuff in the women's mass start. Certainly a little bit unusual if you're not used to it, but it does create drama. It builds throughout, and those intermediate sprints really crucial in the end for positions four through till eight. But another big day here in the James Sheffield Skating Oval for Japan. taking first and second with Masaki Shino and Takahashi Yuka. Well, there will be some ice maintenance, but these are still the unofficial results. But we're feeling here that these will get confirmed. We didn't see too much. There was a couple of wobbles earlier on, but it all settled down provisionally still, but we think almost certainly confirmed. Shino Masaki taking gold from a Japanese teammate, Takahashi Yuka, and Germany's Josephine Heimel taking the bronze medal. Well, the men's mass start consists of 24 athletes. A few to look out for at the top of the order. Arito Matanaga from Japan, LaRue from Canada, and Di Stefano from Italy all have already medaled here. Also look out for Ricardo Lorello from Italy. He took the 5,000 meters, Lorello, and he'll be wearing helmet number 48. Di Stefano with 50 and Arito with 53. Japanese athlete looking to claim Japan's sixth gold medal in the speed skating. This is the final event. Final event for speed skaters at these 2023 FISU World University Games. 16 laps of the men's mass start.
From Japan, Arito Motonaga, wearing helmet number 2. From Canada,
Arito with a couple
David
of bronze medals. David LaRue with the bronze in the 1,000 meters.
Daniela Di Stefano.
Di Stefano from Italy got the silver in the 5,000. I was part of the pursuit team who medaled, got bronze.
Balazs-Bashi. And helmet number 206 from Canada, Hubert Marco.
Marco, part of the Canadian team that took the bronze medal in that team pursuit. So we've actually had a few knocked out here. Harris from Great Britain, Barraclis from Switzerland, and Bodai from Hungary all electing not to take part. So just 20 runners in this. And the men's mass start is underway.
Helmet 7 from Korea, Chung Yang-gun. Helmet 8 from France, Mathieu Belour. Helmet 9 from Poland, Jackie Jatrowski. Helmet 10 from Kazakhstan, Bakhtalay Sagotov. Helmet number 11 from the USA, Tommy Fitzgerald.
So leading the way.
Italy, helmet 212, Ricardo Lorello. Helmet number 13 from Spain, Manuel Robla. Helmet 214 from Spain, Alexander Resnico. Helmet 15 from Norway, Joran Antoine Slekin. Helmet number 216 from Hungary, Balázs Bode. Helmet number 17 from Switzerland, Thibaut Metro. Helmet 18 from Germany, Leonard Norman Yash. Helmet number 219 from Kazakhstan, Andrei Zuev. Helmet 220
so
from Poland,
early here.
Karczewski. Helmet number 221 from Switzerland, Dietrich Pericles. Helmet 222 from France.
Polish athlete taking to the front of the field.
Great Britain, Jocko Veldsman. Helmet number 225 from Norway.
Koshevsky pushing out the Hurley very hard.
From Japan, Yanagaki Yuto.
Koshevsky has pulled out a big lead already now. He's doing all the work up front.
Coming up to the bell for our first sprint. Our current leader is helmet number 220.
So they're getting the bell at the end of the third lap. Koshevsky pushing hard. Now Sagatov and Zuev, the two Kazakh athletes, are in the hunt for points here.
Stay right on each other's hip to break the speed. Our first sprint points are going to go to Karshuski. 3 points for the sprint unofficially. Looks like he's going to let
So Koshevsky from Sagatov and Varikles getting the points in the first sprint.
As you can imagine, a lot of strategy in this race, deciding who's going to pull. There are teams out there. You can see the team from Italy has pulled up into the lead, and they've found each other.
They settle in, Norello and Di Stefano up the front. Two Italians electing to just hold things up at the front of the field.
See, they've really packed up, and they're almost three lanes wide at this point in time, working in unison. It was great to see that we were able to get this race off today with our snow this morning. An incredible job by
Norello,
officials and volunteers.
5,000 meter gold medalist, leading an Italian 1-2.
It's been just incredible for everyone that's been part of this. We're coming out to last nine.
Tanigaki Yuto, who is
we have
in the mix as well at the moment.
Medalist in this group from this week.
So taking to the front as they get the bell on this sprint lap. Varikles from Switzerland, and that is the number 10 from Kazakhstan who's gone down. Dulet Sagatov falling way off the back here.
And again, this is a sprint point. 3-2-1.
Chasing down the points here in the second intermediate sprint. It's the Hungarian who's stepped up and taken the points. Veshi from Norello, from Di Stefano. One more intermediate sprint at lap 12. But as you can see, the three leaders, well, in fact, four leaders, are just trying to split the field up a little bit.
Number 11 in the lead. For a second there, Tommy Fitzgerald.
And now Thomas Fitzgerald puts himself in the mix, sitting in fourth place for the USA. Still, the two Italians, Lerao and Di Stefano, trying to stay out the front.
Lennart
Jasch, who's stepped into the mix from Germany.
That's helmet number 18, Jasch from Germany.
Fitzgerald pushing hard at the front, but Jasch took lap 10 from Lorraine Di Stefano. Fitzgerald now pressing out at the front. Now, an early break from the American, Thomas Fitzgerald.
It's the American, Tommy Fitzgerald.
And into the final sprint here. Fitzgerald breaks the line first, leaning out and pushing hard. Yash in second. Sneaking from Norway, got into the mix there, but he's been pushed back out again. And this time, it's the Italians again pushing for position here. So Fitzgerald, Yash, and Di Stefano taking the sprint points in the final intermediate sprint. And now it's a race to the line.
Who it's going to be, we'll find out.
So the conclusion of the intermediate sprints, points being shared out by a large number as Yash now breaks out to the front, and Mathieu Belvoir's got in the mix. And as you can see, Lorello's still in there. Chart for Arito. He's now started to pump hard. So Arito will cross the line to complete lap 14. And he's saying, well, now it's time for me to show you what can be done over the last 800 meters. It's a brave move early doors. Arito lapping. Yash and Arnwood directly behind him, or I say directly behind him, 20 odd meters behind him, but Arito pushing hard now to complete this lap as the other Kazakh gets out of the way. Arito crossing the line first for the final lap. From Di Stefano and Arn from Korea, Italy and Korea. Now Arito is trying to hold on here, and the Canadian has stepped up into the mix. Well, this is getting a super fast. The Canadian's gone up front and a big fall there as well. This is huge. The Canadian waiting for the last minute and crosses the line in first place. What a brilliant sprint finish from David LaRue, taking out Daniel Di Stefano for second place. The Italian was in the front for most of the race. And Hubert Marcotti is the provisional bronze medal finisher. But what on earth happened to Arito? Arito Motonaga took a big risk sprinting out with more than two laps to go, but David LaRue kept his cool and came over the line to take the gold medal. We have to wait for the provisional results to be confirmed, but provisionally, David LaRue with gold, Daniele Di Stefano of Italy with the silver, and Hubert Marcotti of Canada with the bronze medal. Take a look down at Thomas Fitzgerald taking a push early doors. And then Arito, he really went for this crossing, Yash. And it was a good 1,000 meters to go when Arito pressed the accelerator. And then it was just a slip from Arito in his efforts to haul in David LaRue that had overtaken him on the outside. Arito with an unforced error. But David LaRue picked his moment to take the sprint. Now, from the pictures we've seen, I can't see any reason for anyone to be penalized for Arito's fall. Fitzgerald picked his moment, took the lead, and took the gold medal. Canada first and third with LaRue and Marcotti sandwiching Di Stefano from Italy in the silver medal position. We will, of course, wait for confirmation from the judges. Thank you. great camaraderie amongst the athletes here. David LaRue getting congratulated from athletes and coaches from all the other delegations. Thomas Fitzgerald just behind them. Ian came over the line in 11th place. Seems happy with his efforts here today. And here's the fall from Morito. Oh, now did the hand come through? In fact, it was the Korean that cut across, and it was the Korean number 7 that went down. Now, did that put Morito off? That's the question. Well, Chung Yang Hun came from nowhere, created a fall. And there is Morito. Number 1 was certainly in the mix. Ended up coming across the line in 7th place. It wasn't him that fell in the end, it was the Korean who had somehow blasted his way from way back to be in the mix at the end. So he went into lap number 16, or going crossing the line for lap number 15. The Korean was nowhere in sight. Pushed through to 6, and perhaps inspired by David LaRue on the left there, who started his push at that point. The Korean thought, well, I'm going to go for this as well. Didn't make it to the end. So still unofficial, but we think they should be confirmed fairly shortly. David LaRue from Canada taking gold from Daniele Di Stefano of Italy and Hubert Marcotti from Canada on finishing in 4th position. And it was Piotrowski from Poland in 5th. Well, brilliant stuff from the Canadians here in the men's mass start, the last of the speed skating events here at the brilliant James Sheffield Arena. And here are the final standings. David LaRue from Canada taking gold, his second individual gold here at the competition, from Daniele Di Stefano of Italy in 2nd place, and Hubert Marcotti of Canada taking a 2nd medal for the Canadian team here in the men's mass start. Brilliant finish to a superb speed skating competition here at the 2023 FISO World University Games.